bien paso a Jesús. Mas la gente se acercaba para ver al que llevaba aquella cruz. Él sangraba por la espalda, cruel castigo recibió. Fue de espinas la corona que llevó, y sufrió más al saber que su muerte esa gente iba a pedir. Por la vía dolorosa, que es la vía del dolor, como oveja vino Cristo, Rey Señor, y fue el quien quiso ir por su amor. Por ti y por mí, por la vía dolorosa al Calvario y a morir. The blood that will cleanse the souls of all men made its way through the heart.
Very soon, we're gonna see Jesus soon. See the King very soon. We're gonna see Jesus soon. See the King very soon and very soon. We are going to see the King.
Thank you. Who gives this bride? Friends and family of the bride and groom, and especially you, Jessica and Billy, on this day of your wedding day, we first want to thank God for this wonderful opportunity and wonderful celebration that we have. So let's go ahead and begin in prayer. Our dear Heavenly Father, we are so thankful for this beautiful day you've blessed us with. We're thankful that we can together enjoy this beautiful time together where we watch these two, Jessica and Billy, join together in their marriage. We're thankful for this wonderful union that we're about to witness. We're thankful for the lives that they lead, the examples that they set for us as they serve you, and as they show us how to love. We're thankful that you have shown us how to love most of all by sending your Son on this earth to die on the cross for our sins. And it's through his name that we pray. Amen. You can go ahead and be seated. So I was told that this was the time where I get to tell some stories. And as Jessica's brother, I have plenty of them. But instead of talking for what could be hours full of great stories and potentially embarrassing things, I'll just say this. Now, Jessica, I'm proud of the woman that you've become, that you've grown up to be. You've come a long way since the two-year-old who tried to bite me and then lie about it. But in all seriousness, I'm proud of the strong Christian woman you are and the example that you set for so many. And Billy, I know we haven't known each other that long, but I've still observed these things, that you love my sister, that you care for her, and that you have a strong faith that will bless both you and her in your marriage. And I hope you realize how lucky you are. Now, with that said, don't mess it up. Now, before we continue throughout this ceremony, I believe that Jesse has a few things that he would like to say.
Am I on? Can you hear me? So I was asked to share a story. Honestly, it's really hard for me to pick a story because, last 25 years, Billy's been interwoven into my life. I'm 7 years older than Billy. I remember begging my mom for a sibling. And I remember when he came along, it was kind of like when you're 6, 5, 6, 7, you're asking for the sibling because you kind of want somebody your age to play with. And so when they actually come and you're 7, you're like, I'm so much older than dude. And like, this isn't fun. It wasn't what I imagined. But here he was, 6, 7, 8 years old, following me everywhere I went. My mom said, he wants to be like you. He wants to follow you wherever you go. And I'm like, Mom, like, I'm going to the skating ring and I'm like trying to talk to girls and you're making me take him with me. And he's trying to, like, skate. Like, I'm not trying to skate at the skating rink. It's like me and my friends. Like, it's like me and my 14-year-old friends are trying to go hang out. And I have to take, like, my 8-year-old brother with me. And the thing was, is, like, he did want to follow me. He did want to do everything I did. And, like, at the time, I, like, kind of took that for granted in a lot of ways. But the big thing, like, I mean, it was like, if I did something bad, he did it. Like, I stole Yu-Gi-Oh cards, he stole Yu-Gi-Oh cards. When I went to church, he went to church. When I started going to church, Billy was like, well, I want to come to church, because that's what you do. And, like, so Billy kind of was, like, in my shadow in a lot of ways, and I know there's a lot of time in his life he probably didn't like that. But I want you to know, like, to watch him follow in my footsteps and the things that I pursue in life. And the things that matter most. It's not like Billy's my son by any means, but I do feel like I helped raise him in a lot of ways. And, like, I can only hope that my son does that same stuff. Like, him pursuing what I pursued and what I care about. And, like, one of the things I hope so much for him is that he would find a woman that loved God. And he did. And, Jessica, I'm so happy for y'all. I didn't really have a story exactly. It was more just sentimental stuff. But I believe in relationships. I believe investing. When I was 20 and I got married, my brother was 13 and he was my best man. He couldn't do anything we did. Like, well, that night before we hung out, it was like, you got to go home and go sleep. You know, like, but it's just lots of things like that. But I believed in investing in a relationship because, again, Billy has been interwoven into my life. And he is the friend that I always hoped for when I was 7, asking for a sibling. He is everything and more that I wanted in that moment. So I am so glad that it became that. I was asked to read a couple of verses, so I'm going to read those now. The first one is Ephesians 4:2. It says, be completely humble and gentle, be patient, bearing with one another in love. And then I'm also asked to read the classic Corinthians at this time. And I'm going to read that, and then I'm going to do something a little different too. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. Now, I remember reading that before Leslie and I got married. And at this moment, I'm reading it, and that may just have washed over you because we've heard that verse a lot. I would like to come back and reframe some stuff, and I kind of just translate it a little bit so hopefully it doesn't wash over you and you can understand. Love waits, even when it doesn't want to. Even when that means you're going to be late. Love comforts and gives hugs and back rubs. It is not jealous, but instead excited. It is not obnoxious or overly talks about itself. Instead, it is humble. Love is polite. It is kind. It is selfless, even tempered. Love forgives and love forgets. It doesn't keep bringing up something you did wrong from 3 years ago. Love has joy in truth. Love seeks and gives shelter from evil. Love is strong. Love is worthy. Love is hope, and it can never die. After all is lost, there will be three things that remain: faith, hope, and love. But the strongest and the biggest and the most important is love. Love cannot be stopped.
Thank you, Jesse, Jessica, and Billy. You have come before your family and your friends, and most importantly, before God, to enter this deeper stage of commitment in your relationship, where God designed marriage to be something beautiful and something wonderful, something between one man and one woman for life, designed to last as long as life takes you. It's more than just a ceremony. You know, marriage is more than just what we're doing here, but it's a lifelong commitment where you mutually submit to one another as you mutually submit and serve God together. Billy, God has given husbands some serious responsibilities. You are to love your wife more than you love yourself. You are to love your wife as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her. And Jessica, you too have some serious responsibilities. To love your husband more than you love yourself. To be a companion to him as you both seek to honor God and lead one another and your families to heaven together. Now, before your family and God, you will, in just a few moments, make your vows of love to one another and be joined in marriage. And your action of sharing these vows demonstrates and speaks very powerful to all of us about the hope and promise and joy that we have about love. But before we begin all of that, I would like to just briefly remind you of some of the words in Genesis chapter 2. And I'm going to read these starting in verse 18. It says, "Then the Lord God said, 'It is not good for man to be alone. I will make him a helper suitable for him.' Out of the ground the Lord formed every beast of the field and every bird of the sky and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called the living creature, that was its name. The man gave names to all the cattle and to the birds of the sky and to every beast of the field. But for Adam there was not found a helper suitable for him. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and he slept. And then he took one of the ribs and closed up the flesh at that place. And the Lord God fashioned into a woman the rib which he had taken from man and brought her to the man. The man said, 'This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and his mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh.'" See, this passage tells us that God intended for marriage to be between a man and a woman, and he intended for his husband and his wife to be teammates and not competitors. You know, we read that God designed all these things to happen where they could work together and they could become one in marriage. And that means you could have happiness and prosperity in life. So don't let those who talk about marriage as something that is broken or old-fashioned or for old-timers or even outdated. And don't let those who make it sound like a commitment to your soulmate for life before God, family, and friends is a bad thing. But in fact, it's something to be respected. Marriage is a good thing when God is in control. And as we continue through this ceremony today, we need to keep those thoughts and those words in mind today. So now it's time for the vows. So before God and your family, do you, Billy, take Jessica to be your wife, to have and to hold, for better or for worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and health, as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Do you, Jessica, take Billy to be your husband, to have and to hold, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and health, as long as you both shall live? Now, Billy, do you have a ring for Jessica? Would you put it on her hand and repeat after me? This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
I promise to love.
I promise to love.
Cherish, honor, and respect.
Cherish, honor, and respect.
You all the days of my life.
You all the days of my life.
Jessica, do you have a ring for Billy? Would you put on his hand and repeat after me? This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
I promise.
I promise.
To love, cherish. Honor and respect you.
Honor and respect you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Now, Jessica and Billy, I cannot help but believe that it's because of your faith and your hope and your love that you found one another. And as Jesse echoed, it's wonderful to see two people who truly love God and love each other and want to serve each other and serve God together. And I can't help but think that that's why you found each other, and that's what our Heavenly Father wants to see, and that he wants you to be happy, to be fulfilled, and to live in prosperity. And I know that whatever the future brings, whatever unexpected twists, whatever speed bumps, whatever turns, journey of life may bring you, that your determination, your love, and your support, and your faith in God will help you get through anything life presents you. Before we do the presentation and my power vested in me, we're going to say one more prayer, and then we'll meet the new couple. Dear Heavenly Father, we are so excited to share this journey with Jessica and with Billy. We're so thankful that their love is a wonderful example of how we should love each other and how we should respect each other. And we ask you to bless them as they start their their new life together. Help them to not lose sight of that. Help them to continue to respect each other, continue to love each other, and continue to be an example for us to look to and how to serve you and how to live faithfully and how to love those around them and build each other up. We're thankful again for your son, and it's through his name that we pray. Amen. So now, by the power vested in me by the state of Arkansas, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Jessica and Billy Stacy. Everyone for coming out this afternoon. The family has asked that you stick around for the reception in the ministry center, but the family has been asked to stick around. So that's what we'll be doing. So everyone else can make their way back around to the family resource, or the ministry center, sorry, at the gymnasium. And if you don't know where it is, just follow the crowd. Thank you, guys.
Don't marry.
I know, but I want.
I got my mouth open. You know what?